Well, how's it going, ladies and gentlemen? My name is Grovana, and welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 3. In the last episode, we completed... No, we didn't. I was going to say we completed the pit, but in the last episode, we actually completed the quest Trouble on the Homefront that dealt with Vault 101. In this episode, I was going to go back and do some main quests, but I just realized we're pretty much at the end of the main quest, and I didn't realize how Broken Steel worked. I totally forgot, but basically, Broken Steel is a DLC that adds on to the main quest, and you can't do the story missions in Broken Steel, which again is a DLC, until you complete the main quest. So what we're going to do here is we're going to turn in the American Dream, and then after that it's going to start the final quest for the main quest, but then we're going to be doing some side quests, because I want to do all of the side quests in this Let's Play, because as I've been saying many times, the side quests are awesome. So first thing we're going to do, like I said, is we're going to turn in this quest. So the American Dream, report to Elder Lions at the Citadel. If you have no idea what's going on, you remember that we got captured by the Enclave. And then we talked to President Eden, which was actually a computer, and he wanted us to take the FEV, or the Forced Evolutionary Virus, and put that into the purifier to eradicate all of the mutants in the wasteland. So our objective now is to report to Elder Lions at the Citadel. There he is. Let's see what he has to say.
All I'm saying is, the longer we sit here, the more time they have to shore up their defenses. We should hit them sooner rather than later.
We barely have the manpower to keep the Citadel fortified. We've been over this before, Sarah.
So we just wait until they decide we're next on the list? If the Pride goes in now, we might have a chance.
And if you fail, then what? The risk is not worth the reward.
I agree. Without the Gek, the Purifier is useless to the Enclave anyway. They may give up before long.
I don't like it.
You don't have to like it, Sarah. You just have to follow orders.
Yes, Father.
So, you're back. We had feared both you and the Gek were lost. Were you successful?
Well, sort of. I found the Gek.
Excellent. With that, we hold the key to keeping the Enclave from controlling the Purifier.
Well, it's not quite that simple.
What do you mean? Explain yourself.
I don't have to explain anything. I don't answer to you. Or the Enclave took the Gek. They're installing it now.
Then we must go at once. If you have any other information, tell me now before we mobilize. Any help you can give might save lives.
Eden wanted me to sabotage the project with some kind of virus. The Enclave is fractured. They're not as unified as they'd like us to believe. The Enclave doesn't have the activation code. They can't start the purifier. Raven Rock is destroyed. Well, all of this stuff is information that we should tell this guy. Let's go with Raven Rock is destroyed.
Is it now? That's an unexpected but welcome surprise. Hopefully it'll reduce their ability to defend themselves. With that in mind, we need to revise our strategy.
If the Enclave has the Gek, there's nothing stopping them from starting the purifier. They'll figure out the code eventually.
I'm afraid you're right. We need to act now while we can.
Send the Pride in. We can do it. We can win this.
All right, Sarah. The Pride goes in. But I want them to have some extra firepower. Rothschild, is it ready?
What? No, I mean, Lee and I have solved the power problems, but we've only barely finished diagnostic tests.
So?
It's not ready for field tests, let alone live fire situations. The weapons haven't been calibrated, the navigation detection system is offline.
Rothschild, enough. Can you make it work?
Honestly? I don't know. I think we can scrape by, and I suppose if we can't, it won't matter in the long run anyway.
Then it's decided. Sarah, you take the Pride and use the robot as support. Take our friend here and secure that purifier.
Yes, sir. Before we get started, I wanted to let you know that my father and I have been talking. The Pride and I have decided that after all you've survived, you've done enough to be an honorary member of Lion's Pride.
Aw, yeah.
So congratulations. Membership comes with some privileges, including our power armor. You want the full suit or the recon armor?
Well, considering I would never use the full suit, I'll take the recon armor.
All right, here you go. I hope it fits. So you think you can handle this?
Of course I can. I sure hope so. I don't know, Sarah. I'm not too sure about this. Of course I can.
Now that's what I like to hear, soldier. You all packed? We're not coming back here anytime soon.
I think I need another minute or two.
Hurry it up! Every minute you take is one more that we can't afford to spend.
Yeah, I know, and unfortunately, they're going to have to wait here and hope that the Enclave doesn't completely destroy them, because we're going to take care of a lot of different stuff before we finish off this main quest. I wanted to save the main quest for the finale like I did with Let's Play Oblivion, but it doesn't look like that's going to work because I want to complete everything, and like I said, you can't do Broken Steel until you complete the main quest, so we'll probably save Broken Steel for last, even though it's not my favorite DLC, but, you know, it's sort of poetic to save the main quest finale for the finale. So, what we're going to do now is we're going to do some side quests, and we've done a lot of them, so there might not be that many left. But there is a good portion, and so I'm going to go to the first one that I want to do, and you guys are about to see that in one split second. Alright, so here we are at the Moresti train yard. I'm 90% sure that this is where the family was. If you remember way back when we started this Let's Play and we did the vampire quest, Blood Ties, I think it was called. Anyways, where we want to go is where I've placed that map marker, and it's sort of over that hill, and that's where you can start one side quest here. That's not a ladder that we can climb, so let's see if we can do some Bethesda parkouring, as I like to call it, whenever you have to jump over a mountain, and it's, you just gotta find these little ledges. Come on, right there, let's go. Okay, let's go over here and then jump up. Yeah, I don't know if we're gonna be able to do this, but hopefully we can. So yeah, this place is right next to the Moresti train yard, and what I'm trying to do is hop over this hill. I can do it. Who am I kidding? I mean, I'm not kidding anybody. What I mean is, I can do it, of course, because I've played so many Bethesda games for so many hours that I've gotten the hang of scaling mountains and such. Alright, so we're heading off in this direction. It should be fairly close. In fact, it's probably... Yes, I see it. Okay, so that there's a radio tower over there, and that's what we want. We also have what looks like a traveling caravan here. Let's just see what they're selling. Who is it? Crow? I think he sells weapons, if I'm right.
See if anything calls out to you.
Oh, he sells apparel. Okay, we don't want to bother with him for now. See you later, Crow. I've got somebody to meet. Alright, so let's go ahead and take this map marker off. There we go. And I think we want to go through here. Yes, Agatha's house. There we go. So there's a radio tower there, and there's a house here, and I don't think there's anything on the outside. Let's head inside and see what's going on. Okay. Ah, there's a woman there, and there's also a bed, and the normal facilities you would think there would be in a house, obviously. Alright, so let's talk to this woman.
My, my, my. You certainly do look a little bit worn out from your travels. Oh, just look at my terrible manners. I'm Agatha. It's so nice to meet you. Now, what brings you all the way out here?
That's funny. I was about to ask you the same thing. Exploring. I prefer to keep my business to myself, and I suggest you do the same. Ah, why would we do that option to such a nice lady? That's funny. I was about to ask you the same thing.
Oh, don't worry about me. I'm just fine out here. My husband, rest his poor soul, saw to it that our house was well protected from the elements and the inhabitants of the wastes.
And if you didn't notice, this house is located like in the niche of a little mountain, so she's right. Oh, your husband's dead. I'm sorry. I take it you don't get many visitors then. Oh, boo-hoo. People die all the time. I take it you don't get many visitors then.
Apart from supply caravans, you're the first person to set foot inside my house in a long time. It's not for lack of trying at this point, mind you. I'm just far off the beaten path. Living in this isolation protects me. But it has also made me very lonely.
Surely you haven't severed all contacts. A frail old lady like yourself should be careful out here all alone. Old lady alone, huh? Got anything valuable around? In fact, she does. Let's cut to the chase. Is there something you need? Surely you haven't severed all contacts. Actually, let's cut to the chase. Is there something you need?
You're very blunt. Not always a good trait, but sometimes it is the best way to get things done. My trading depends on my violin. Without it, I have nothing to play, no way to make music. If you can bring me a violin, a better one, I'd feel much more secure.
A violin? That's hardly something that would have survived the war. I'm interested, but what will you give me in return? I'd get you a damn moon rock if you pay well enough. A violin, that's hardly something that would have survived the war.
Yes, very sad, isn't it? Sad to think that no more musical instruments will ever be made the old way ever again. Well, fortunately, I know where perhaps the last real violin in the world exists. If you give me your word that you will recover it, I will tell you more.
This sounds like a quest to me, ladies and gentlemen. Charisma, you seem like a nice woman. Let me get that violin for you. Speech 100%. I want to help you, but that type of search could cost me greatly. Speech 100%. Look, Granny, talk is cheap, but getting stuff isn't. All right, I'll give you my word. I need some time to think about it. Let's go with, you seem like a nice, we'll do the speech challenge. I want to help you, but that type of search could cost me greatly.
You have a point. Perhaps I've been neglecting needs that you might have and being selfish. I have a small amount of ammunition that my husband left behind. A box of odds and ends. I don't think I've opened it in years. If you do this for me, you're welcome to take whatever you need.
Okay, ammo doesn't sound like that great of a reward, but we will be helping this nice old woman. All right, I'll give you my word. I'll do my best to recover a violin for you.
Oh, I don't think I've been this happy in years. As promised, here's the key to the ammunition box. It's right under the radio table. Before you leave, I have some information that may help you, at least a place to begin. It all starts with my great-great-grandmother Hilda back in 2077, before the bombs fell.
You have records from back then? 2077? I can't even imagine that long ago. Sorry to interrupt, but where can I find the violin? More stories? Ugh. Sorry to interrupt, but where can I find the violin?
I'm sorry. I know I tend to ramble. Comes from being lonely. If you insist, I'll get right to the heart of the matter then. I'm looking for a particular violin, not just any. The violin you're looking for is called the Soie Stradivarius. It's located in Vault 92, where my great-great-grandmother once lived.
Any idea where Vault 92 is located?
That's the catch. I have no idea where it is. I'd suggest making your way to Vault-Tec headquarters in the DC ruins. That would be a good place to begin. Good luck!
Okay, tell me a bit about your great-grandmother. What do you know about the Soie Stradivarius? Do you have any information on Vault 92? I don't think she does. Yeah. Can you tell me anything about Vault-Tec headquarters? Let's see, tell me a bit about your grandmother. What do you know about the Soie, whatever it's called? How will I know the Stradivarius when I see it? Trust me, we'll know. Is the Stradivarius worth a ton of caps? Oops. I didn't mean to say that. Let me ask you something else. Okay, I have to go now.
Watch yourself out there.
Alright, so, two things with this location before we go. First is this ammunition box she was talking about that has a lot, actually. 6 .308 caliber rounds, 44, 10mm, 5.56, 5mm, energy cells, microfusion cells, mini-nuke, which is the best thing about that, and a missile. And also, before we leave here, if we go into sneak and pickpocket her, we can't see it. I'm pretty sure that she has a unique, like, scoped magnum, if I'm right. So, actually, let me check that really quickly. I'm pretty sure she does. Let's see. Agatha, and what does Agatha have? Inventory wasteland. No, I guess she doesn't. I don't know, I think she does still. Anyways, we need to find Vault 92, and it should have, like, because remember, as part of the main quest, we saw where all the vaults were located, so, let's see, we have a new quest here, Agatha's Song, optional locate Vault-Tec headquarters, recover the soil, Soie Stradivarius from Vault 92. Let's see, so there's Vault-Tec headquarters, and, yeah, there's Vault 92, so because we talked to Rothschild, and we were able to see where all the vaults were located. We can skip that part where we need to find the locations of all the vaults. So luckily we did things in the order that is efficient. All right, so now we need to head to Vault 92. Let's go ahead and heal up a bit because we're about at half health from fighting a rad scorpion off camera. And I will see you guys at Vault 92. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, holy crap, we are starting to see the effects of being a semi-high level here. We're at, like, level 19, which is the cap. Well, 20 is the cap for the base game, but because we have Broken Seal, we can get to 30. But yeah, we're fighting a couple of giant rad scorpions. There's still another one back there somewhere, and there's also, like, Enclave Hellfire troops. So we need to get the hell into Vault 92 or whatever it is. What is this, Brotherhood of Steel? Oh, great. Yeah, guys, there's some freaking, Outcasts. Yeah, there's some Enclave troops over there that are kicking my ass. I've never even seen, like, Hellfire troops, so that was weird. But yeah, I had to use a lot of Simpacks there. But Vault 92 should be somewhere around here. Okay, it also completes the optional objective, which is kind of funny considering we didn't do it. Let's head into Vault 92. And also we need to use some stim packs because we're about at half health. And they almost took me down to no health. But I also used some stim packs before then too. Alright, so let's use... There we go. Alright, so this is Vault 92. This is one of the vaults in the game. I think there's around 7 or so. And I think like maybe 3 or 4 are non-quest related. Alright, so the vault door is already open. Which is either a good or a bad sign. I don't know. Also a lot of energy cells here. And blood pack. And a couple of first aid boxes. I've mentioned before that each vault has like some specific goal. Alright, let's also get our perforator out, or infiltrator, or whatever this thing was called. The assault rifle that we got from the pit. Oh god! Okay. What is this bloatfly doing? Goodbye. So there's mines in here, so we gotta be careful. Yeah, and so this one, I believe, should be music related. And you can see it's not giving us a quest marker here, so this is just one of those quest where we have to find it for ourselves. Alright, so let's try opening this. There we go. We are running low on... Come on now. Why would you put it right behind the door? Well, I always complain that Bethesda games are too easy, so I guess that does present a challenge that we haven't really seen before. Alright, so let's open this. And by that I mean, you know, like as soon as we exit, there's a mine, which would be a good location for a mine if you consider... The goal is to try and kill us. Who's placing these mines? These freaking bloatflies? Those bastards. Okay, let's keep going this way. I would assume that it's easier to get to the hidden stuff, like the violin we're looking for, if you go through locked doors. You know what I mean? Because it's just like, it's harder to go through those. Well, it's easier, but, you know, sometimes you might not have the stuff to do it. Okay, so we're on the lookout for a violin, and I seem to remember what it looks like. If I remember right, it's like very illustrious and it's really hard to miss once you find the location. So it's probably going to be in the depths of this place. Sound testing sounds like a good place. So I don't know if I finished my point, but yeah, this vault should be sound related, music related, all that sort of stuff. Is that a Mire Lurk? It sure is. Yeah, I forgot about that. There are Mire Lurks in this one. Alright, so let's just explore every door pretty much, or every room, because we definitely don't want to miss it. There's also stuff in here that we want to get as well, like a pre-war book, but there should be like, okay, we can probably just sneak past this guy. I don't like fighting Mire Lurks because, I don't like fighting Mire Lurks because they just take so much damn bullets, and this being a survival game in the wasteland, you want to conserve all that you can. All right, so there's nothing in here. What I was trying to say was we also want to be on the lookout for any... what is it, musical paper, or notation paper, musical notation paper, whatever, because I think Agatha pays you if you get any of those too, so yeah, we want to be on the lookout for that, and I think there are quite a bit in here. Okay, so atrium, let's head downstairs. In fact, I think it might be in this location, this violin, in this room, in this area. So, because I remember sound testing being a place. Oh, okay, so one of these guys. Yeah, these guys are creepy as hell. What are they called? Mirelurk Kings. Yeah, and you can see they're basically like evolved versions. Let's see how much damage he takes. Okay, that's good. So one VATS go basically kills in one hit. Alright, so that's good. Heard one VATS thing. Mirelurk meat, soft shell Mirelurk meat, and there's a pre-war book, which we'll take. Anything else in here? There's a Nuka-Cola that might have the quantum. No. I guess it's not gonna happen. Oh, there's also a jukebox here.
You're listening to Galaxy.
And it's just basically a radio. Let's shut that off. I don't think there's a mechanic in this game that, like, alerts things when you play, like, the radio and stuff, which would have been cool. Okay, I hate losing lockpicks because we're running really low. No, where are you? Come on, help me out here. Let's see, right there, there we go. Okay, so what's in here? Looks like just a bunch of ammo. Railway spikes, couple of stim packs. We've got a safe here, not even gonna... We'll kind of want to bother with it because there might be something important in there. But we'll take all this stuff first. Ammunition box with 3 missiles. Ammunition box with 11 shotgun shells. Psycho, a whole bunch of drugs, and a stealth boy, which I just realized we don't even need. Alright, so let's try opening this, and then we'll end the episode. Okay, come on. You always gotta love when it does that, and there's only 8 bottle caps, that's what I was talking about. Alright, so in the next episode, we'll probably finish off this side quest, and we'll also start a new one, probably, most likely. Thanks for watching, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Grovana, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Thanks for watching this episode, ladies and gentlemen, I do hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, please remember to like and share the video wherever you can, it really helps me out. If you have a question or a suggestion, Twitter is the best way to get in touch with me, and if you'd like to subscribe or watch another video that's going to be related to this one, you can click the annotations on the screen. Thanks again, and I'll see you in the next one.